Kolege obrazovanja i pomoći da ovom svih interesu je stvarno i ostvare. Meni je jako drago što smo dobili Erasmus projekat, gde ćemo tu našu pamet integrisati u vlastu. Dakle, kroz godinu dana bit će dosta zelenije u matematičkoj gimnaziji, a imat ćemo i zdravu granu da se poslužimo svakako. Ja vam želim samim tim što smo svi ovdje, mislim da je poprilično već sve ovo jako uspješno. Hajmo da radimo.
Samo još jedno stvar, jer je pozdravo Dušan Rakić. Dušan Rakić je učestvovao iz Vršca, on je prvi pobednik u prilogu izazova i isto učestvovao sada u kreiranju zadataka, a kasnije ćemo se obratiti malo i prezentovati
high schools in Mishwara that are hundred names of people who are citizens of Serbia, but they are studying in Tijuana. Besides the formal education system, there are several communities and major events that are attended by kids like you. There is a quite big hackathon happening each year in Tijuana, FDM, the biggest one with 600 participants, out of which there were a dozen or two coming from Serbia. There is another one, UNITEC, organized by the Polytechnic University, that's also open to students. And typically, I think that half of the prizes are won by high school kids, so it's feasible to go there and make good results. There are also co-working spaces. It's worth taking a look and attending events on your specific interest. There is also a small business angel group that I've started 6 years ago that is looking for interesting startups, not only for Romania, but in our portfolio, startups from UK, from Poland, and so on. But what's our own fingerprint on the local system? So it's the local implementation of an Irish-born movement, 13 years old now, that expanded globally with more than 2,000 different locations where kids are learning for free from volunteer mentors in weekly sessions, all sorts of tech-related fields. There are those small ones starting to be Scratch, and I suppose that almost all of you know what's Scratch, huh? Scratch, anyone? Okay. Then they are progressing and they're going skyrocket to the artificial intelligence or the type of things you can imagine. We used to have mixed tunnels, but now we are starting to have a specialized one, and we have others that are focusing on cybersec or game development or on web development, and so quite interesting one and unique. Globally, focusing on bioinformatics, synthetic biology, and computational chemistry, and all these start things that are connected to life science. In Tijuana, right now, we are organizing events with 200 to 300 kids participating on yearly basis, and we are again open, and we had previous participants from Budapest, or I think also from Bancho at some point. Yeah. What is, for example, this one, the cyber tech of the logo? Kids are gathering on things and they're doing the white hashing. We're trying to keep them on the right side of the things. They are participating to major events, for example, big moments. They are organizing villages for white ethnic learning, and they are organizing their own CDS. Some of you know what CDS is, that type of competition, and you're invited to also join. Yeah, there are people like you, quite young ones. The champions, the ones who are coordinating, are 19 years old and have kids in 8th grade or 7th grade that are pretty competitive and winning all sorts of competitions. So what we want to do from now on is to attract more mentors, to establish connections with other educational settings out of the city and out of Romania. You're welcome to join, and we want to transfer the experience and all consider starting of segregation of the program. Where AI is kind of becoming competitive. So I mentioned the next big thing. And
projects are integrating more. But again, it's not the answer to everything, of course. There are multiple scenarios where you see people nowadays just putting the editing for, you know, there's no place for editing. But on the other hand, it can unlock really interesting new projects. For example, it would be so difficult to algorithmically detect a face or a person or track a person around. It would take so much computing power. It's genuinely more efficient to do some math of that with things like AI, and especially in hardware, which is slowly weakening the deep mesh, you know, and that's what you're doing. I don't know if you're familiar with the edge term. It generally means computing that's not centralized, localized, but small compressors. So older new projects can be technical class, but it's an edge project because most of the new patterns right where the sensors are. So basically, I just wanted to tell you all the secret to seek out new technology which interests you, to keep experimenting with things that interest you, and of course, like the other mentors today, you need any company.
Zašto je Tempus fondacija značajna za Srbiju?
Pa upravo zato što ona predstavlja neku vrstu mosta između obrazovnog sistema Srbije i drugih zemalja. Dakle, ona kroz svoj rad promoviše saradnju u obrazovanju sa drugim zemljama. Ja bih ponovo istakao ovaj program Erasmus Plus, u okviru koga je omogućeno školama pre svega da podnose projektne prijave u okviru kojih mogu da obezbede svojim učenicima i nastavnicima da provedu određeni period u inostranstvu u cilju sticanja znanja i veština. Takođe, omogućeno je obrazovnim ustanovama da se udružuju sa obrazovnim ustanovama iz drugih zemalja kako bi rešili neke zajedničke probleme. Recimo, kroz projekte saradnje mogu da, recimo, ako su ustanovile da imaju potrebu da uvedu neki novi predmet, mogu da rade na tome da zajedno osmisle plan i program za taj predmet i zatim pokrenu administrativne procedure za uvođenje tog predmeta.
Kako učestvovati u projektima mobilnosti?
Što se tiče projekata mobilnosti, potrebno je da škole podnesu projektne prijave fondaciji Tempus i da u okviru tih projektnih prijava planiraju mobilnost, odnosno boravak učenika i nastavnika u inostranstvu. Za učenike mogu da planiraju prakse u stranim kompanijama ili boravak u stranim školama, dakle da učenici tamo prate nastavu i tako stiču nova znanja i veštine, a što se nastavnika tiče, moguće je da takođe provedu određeni period u inostranstvu u nekoj stranoj školi ili kompaniji kako bi videli kako njihove kolege rade. Takođe, mogu i da, osim tog, da kažemo, posmatranja na radnom mestu, mogu i sami da drže nastavu u stranim školama, kako bi tako usvojili nove metodologije rada.
Koliko dugo se bavite ovim poslom i kakva su vam iskustva?
Ja u fondaciji Tempus radim već godinu dana, ali imam iskustva sa Erasmusom s programom još ranije, jer sam pre toga radio u školi kao nastavnik engleskog jezika, i sam sam pisao projektnu prijavu i vodio učenike na mobilnost. Tako sam i došao do ovog posla, tako mi se ukazala prilika da pređem na fondaciju Tempus. I iskustva su vrlo pozitivna, rekao bih da je ovaj program vrlo značajan zbog toga što omogućava školama da samostalno rade na unapređenju svog rada.
Hvala.
My name is Radu Tiču, I'm coming from Timișoara, I'm running Coder Dojo and Bio Coder Dojo for that.
What is the significance of Code Dojo for us?
Code Dojo is a global movement trying to offer kids in all sorts of social, economic, ethnic conditions the opportunity to participate to an educational program that opens the doors to technology, to technical creativity, to project work, to collaboration, to lots of different types of learning opportunities. It functions, as I told you, all over the world. It also had a short history here in Serbia, but it definitely can be restarted by a group of passionate mentors that are concerned about the future generation, that have the knowledge that's worth sharing, and definitely if there will be mentors and the venue, the kids will always come to learn and to practice technology.
How can we participate in their programs?
The participation is quite easy. It's open, you just have to get in contact with the headquarters that's located in Ireland to make sure that there is a good understanding of the philosophy of the movement. It's a very simple paperwork that you have to pass, and you just can start delivering the Code Dojo workshops, and you can adapt them to your local needs, to your local mentors' competencies, and to the interest of the participating kids.
What can you expect from the new Build Code Dojo program?
The idea is that there are very important voices, starting with the late Steve Jobs, but continuing with Bill Gates, or with the CEOs, or NVIDIA, for example, that are saying very convinced that the 21st century will bring significant breakthroughs, not in a very limited computer science field, but at the convergence of life science and computer science. You can use the engineering principles in dealing with cells, with tissues, with organisms of all sorts. So right now, someone who is both interested in biology and in computer science can make the best use of the tools and approaches from the two different fields, building various solutions to a quite diverse set of problems, starting from topics related to human health, to planetary health, to reducing the climate impact of our activities in fields like precision production by biological system of all sorts of substances or materials, in terms of preserving the biodiversity. So everything can be improved when you're bringing in the programming next to the knowledge in the biology.
How long have you been doing this job, and how have your experiences been?
It's not a job. I'm doing it voluntarily since 2013 in Timișoara. I have supported and convinced people from all over Romania to start similar things. Also, some friends from Vrsac, for example, started at some point a Code Dojo in their town. It was a continuous learning experience. It's fantastic to see how quickly the kids can progress and how complex projects they are approaching, producing relevant outputs in terms of, relevant relevant projects, and some of them are also developing interesting and high potential startups. It's also interesting to see that beyond the accumulation of technical knowledge and competence, they're evolving as human beings. They're learning how to better communicate, how to collaborate, how to analyze various contexts and find ideas that they can build on, how they are helping each other, how they are communicating their successes and, why not, their failures.